The natural satellite orbiting our planet Earth might be little more than a pretty object to look at in the sky to some, while others may track the moon's phases compulsively. Whilst we often aim to explore as far out into the universe as we possibly can, there is still plenty to discover and explore a little closer to home. From the first moon landing in 1969 to the most recent findings, there is still plenty we are uncovering about our moon. So today, here at Unexplained Mysteries, we'll be taking a look at three moon mysteries and discoveries. Impact Crater Mysteries. Our moon features a gigantic crater. This hole has been on our moon for billions of years, since an unknown object hit the dark side of the moon. We have measured this crater to reach 1,550 miles in width and 8 miles in depth, and so have dubbed it one of the largest craters within our solar system. The presumed explanation for decades was simply that this crater was formed when contact was made between the moon and a rapidly paced meteor. If this had been the case, then there would be pieces from the inside of the moon on the surface possibly available to examine. Some new insight was provided in January 2019, when the U2 rover was sent to the moon from China, which reached the bottom of this mysterious crater. Minute traces of minerals were recorded by U2 too, which appear to have come from within the moon's mantle. In a turn of events, new data came to light within August 2019 from a study published within Geophysical Research Letters. After an analysis was conducted upon the materials found at the bottom of this peculiar crater, it revealed evidence suggesting that the crater was composed entirely of crust, with no mantle. The crust is the outer layer surface of the moon, with the mantle coming just underneath that, similar to Earth. This would imply that an object collided with the moon with enough force to open a colossal crater, but with not enough force to release any of the mantle onto the surface of the moon. Co-author of the new study, Qiao Zhang, planetary scientist working at the China University of Geosciences, explained how the team had anticipated finding the mantle materials at this landing site. He goes on to explain that the lack of mantle organisms rules out the possibility that a meteor traveling with high velocity had caused this crater, eliminating an assumption we had been acting upon for decades. This study employed the use of spectroscopy in order to clarify and identify the minerals that had been found within the lunar soil. This process observes how each grain is reflected within both visible and near-infrared light. This study was carried out using the equipment U22 was already armed with, performing these reflection tests on 6 different areas of soil, ranging up to approximately 175 feet away from the landing site. An already established database allowed each mineral to be identified based upon size, reflectance, and degradation, which often occurs as a result of solar wind. Within every sample, it was evident that the primary mineral in the moon's surface is plagioclase. We know this is common in the crusts of Earth and the moon, but that it isn't likely to be found within the mantle. This mineral composition supports the meteor theory. But then the unanswered question remains as to what created this crater. If it were a meteor, then why aren't there chunks of mantle over the surface? Moon rock given to Holland by Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin turns out to be fake. In 2009, the Dutch National Museum, Rijksmuseum, had a rather bashful announcement to make, with the disappointing revelation that the beloved moon rock is not authentic. While the museum is most well known for fine art exhibitions, one particularly exciting exhibition is Fly Me to the Moon. Front and center in this space-themed piece was what we all thought to be a rock from the moon. This exhibit was first revealed to the public in 2006. The moon rock was intended to symbolize the exploration of faraway, distant places, possible colonization, and bringing home treasures. The thought, love, and excitement represented with this exhibit made the unfortunate reveal of the truth that much more devastating. Originally, the rock was gifted to Willem Dries Jr. in 1969 from the US ambassador to the Netherlands. This gift shortly follows the moon landing. The supposed moon rock was presented from J. William Middendorf II in the midst of a meeting with the famous trio from aboard Apollo 11, Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins. When Dries unfortunately passed away in 1998, the rock was donated to the Rijksmuseum, a permanent home. A museum spokeswoman explained that, since the rock had come from the personal possession of the Prime Minister, no one had thought to consider checking the authenticity, and simply approved the ownership via a phone call with NASA. Apparently, according to the Rijksmuseum, the once believed moon rock had been insured at an estimated $500,000, when in reality, the value is, at a maximum, worth $70. Mr. Middendorf, former US ambassador, attempted to recount the tale, but could not specifically remember how the US State Department acquired the rock at all. It is established and well known that in the 1970s, NASA shared lunar rocks with 100 countries. A space expert, however, expressed his shock that the material was already part of an exhibition in just 2006, and so further research began to take place. The Free University of Amsterdam's researchers jumped on the case, extensively testing and investigating the genuine history of this rock. Ultimately, the tests proved the rock was not authentic, and this lunar adventure keepsake was instead some petrified wood. So far, no one has been able to offer an explanation as to how this scenario could occur. Despite tests proving it's not a moon rock, the curators at Rijksmuseum intend to keep it anyway, as a curiosity item, a souvenir to remember this unusual tale, and to keep it home where it belongs. Where did lunar water come from? Our moon has a rather bizarre phenomenon we are still trying to puzzle our way through. There is lunar water on the moon, despite us not being able to observe a water cycle similar to ours on Earth. A recent study has reported clear evidence that there are water molecules on the surface of or held within the grains of the lunar soil. If we can research what kinds of water are available here, and precisely where that water is, then we may be able to fathom out the seemingly magical water cycle of the moon. Another study with groundbreaking revelations found small areas of the moon that are within a permanent shadow. This creates a cold enough environment for ice to form. Additionally, the space of these areas covers 15,400 square miles, according to National Geographic. Current guesses indicate that the water cycle on the moon is carried through hydrogen in solar wind, reacting with oxygen on the surface. This is a stark contrast to our rain, rivers, seawater cycle here on Earth. Other suggestions have guessed that the lunar water travels, migrating to remain in a shadowed zone, as opposed to one with sun. Exactly how this happens still requires plenty of further research. Jessica Sunshine, University of Maryland planetary scientist, says that these new findings suggest a more complex process than what we thought before. The practical application once we figure this out would be remarkable. This research has useful implications as to how humans may be able to travel, not only to the moon, but further beyond too. The next NASA mission, Artemis, aims to place the first woman and next man on the moon. If we can understand the moon's water cycle before then we may be able to convert the water into a resource for energy. One trial for the lunar water to withstand is the harsh climate of the moon, with a high of 120 degrees Celsius and a more than chilly low of minus 133 degrees Celsius. It wouldn't be improbable for the water to evaporate, especially without a thick atmosphere. But luckily for us, even in the sun, there are still traces of water, though these are faint. Based upon current observations, there appears to be 12 ounces of lunar water to 1 cubic meter, meaning the water, whilst existent, is very sparse. This is 100 times drier than the Sahara Desert. Whilst there is water present on the moon, we need to conduct more observations, more analysis, more research before we take action with this thrilling discovery. Once we know a little more about the intricate process, we may need to implement some man-made intervention for this water to be of use due to its limited supply. This research is being referred to by some as the slow revolution. Whilst new progress is being made and we are slowly beginning to make a clearer picture, but the tedious process could still take decades of more research. Researchers completing this project report that despite having a difficult job, the work is very rewarding, and know that the findings will be worthwhile. Whilst there are so many unanswered questions out in the universe, some of the more interesting ones begin much closer to home. Between unanswered questions and thrilling new research, our moon has a lot of exciting news going on at the moment. But what do you make of these moon mysteries and discoveries? Be sure to let us know your thoughts in the comments section below and help us by growing this community while working to solve these unexplained mysteries. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos.